Good morning and welcome to Prayer and Devotion. Today is Thursday and it is October 6th. That was Lauren Daigle, her song Love Like This from her Look Up Child album. I hope you enjoyed that as we start our day together. Today we are looking at 1 John 4. 1 John 4 beginning in verse 16, actually in the middle of verse 16. So 1 John 4, verse 16. And our title for today's devotion is Being Free to Love, Being Free to Love. Let me say good morning to all of you. Good morning, Yola. I missed your birthday yesterday. I hope you had a wonderful birthday. Happy birthday to you. And continuing to hold you in prayer. I'm glad you're with us today. And good morning, Celia and Michelle. I'm glad you're here praying for both of you today. Good morning, Andrea and Daniel. It's good to have both of you here praying for you as we start the day. And Ernestine and Barbara, I'm glad you're here holding you both in prayer. Good morning, Vinette. And good morning, Priscilla. It's good to have you here praying for you both. And Janet and Blanca, welcome, holding you in prayer today. Good morning, Ingrid and Renetta. It's good to have you both here praying for you both. And Shelley and Sue, I'm glad you're both here holding you both in prayer. Good morning, Betty and Labake. I'm glad you're both here praying for both of you this day, as well as Susan and Barbara Dawson. Good to have you both here praying for you. Good morning, Marilyn Kuna and Andrew. I'm glad you're with us as well, holding you in prayer. And good morning, Augusta. It's good to have you here as well, praying for you today. Praying for all of you as we begin our day together. Today we're going to be in 1 John chapter 4. 1 John chapter 4. Whenever I give someone a Bible and they say, where should we start? Most people will end up starting either in a gospel or in Genesis. And I say, start in the first letter of John, which is towards the end of the Bible. But to me, the words are so important. So we're going to be looking at 1 John 4 today. And as you open up your Bibles, my name is Cindy Stauffer. I'm blessed to serve as a pastor at the United Methodist Church at New Brunswick. And I am glad you're with us today. Good morning, Genevieve. It's good to have you here on this happy Thursday, praying for you today. And looking forward to some sun today. It's been a long kind of dark week, so hopefully we'll get some nice sun in today, which is always helpful to the soul. So as you open, let's take a look at 1 John 4, beginning in the middle of chapter 16. God is love, and those who abide in love abide in God, and God abides in them. Love has been perfected among us in this, that we may have the boldness on the day of judgment, because as he is, so are we in this world. There is no fear in love, but perfect love casts out fear. For fear has to do with punishment, and whoever fears has not reached perfection in love. We love because he first loved us. We love because he first loved us. If you're going to mark something in your Bible, mark that. That's good stuff. So today's devotion comes from Henry Nouwen's Bread for the Journey, and it's entitled Being Free to Love. Jesus came to us to help us overcome our fear of God. As long as we are afraid of God, we cannot love God. Love means intimacy, closeness, mutual vulnerability, and a deep sense of safety. But all of those are impossible as long as there is fear. Fear creates suspicion, distance, defensiveness, and insecurity. The greatest block in the spiritual life is fear. Prayer, meditation, and education cannot come forth out of fear. God is perfect love. And as John the Evangelist writes, perfect love drives out fear. Jesus's central message is that God loves us with an unconditional love and desires our love free from all fear in return. Jesus's central message is that God loves us with an unconditional love. So this month is Domestic Awareness Violence Month. And I think this is so important because there are a lot of people that are living in places of fear, and sometimes their homes are a place of fear. And sometimes they have been miscommunicated that love and control are intertwined, that somehow it's okay to fear, you know, that, you know, we've got to give each other, you know, that they end up forgiving people who then continue to perpetuate violence against them. And I just want to use today as an opportunity to say, that's not love. Violence, living in fear, living fearful for your own life, for the life of your children, that is not love. And I've recently been witnessing this in the midst of our community, not the church community, but this city community. And it's very hard, and I mean, I don't understand it, but I do know that it is very hard to leave those places when you're most afraid. But our job as God's people, and if you are in a place that is violent, I just want you to know that you are loved, and there are other options. There are other options. But what do we do to help people leave those places? And part of it is reminding them that they are loved, that God loves them with a perfect love, a love that has no fear, that there are options where they can get safe, and that you're there for them when they're ready to make the step. It is very tricky. But when we talk about love, my friends, love, true love, God's love, unconditional love, is love beyond fear. Now, if you grew up believing in a vengeful God that was ready to get you at any moment, that if you were not perfect, somehow you deserved what you got, you deserved whatever terrible experience you were going through because somehow you didn't measure up. That is not truth, okay? That is not truth. And all we need to do is turn to God, the scripture today, and read that God is love. And perfect love, there is no fear in perfect love. And so today, two things I want to ask you to do. The first is to remember that, to hold on to that. When you begin to go down roads where you're beating yourself up, which we do as well, you know, we talk about violence, sometimes the violence we do to ourselves, that is not God's intent. Yes, we make mistakes. Yes, we need to turn and return to God. Yes, we need to change our paths. But God meets us with open arms, not vengeful, violent encounter, but a open arms waiting for us. This is the God that we know. So today, hold on to that reminder. God is love. And the second thing, if you know somebody or if you yourself are in a place where you fear, you are fearful, my prayer is that you, first of all, know that you're loved and that when you are ready, or, you know, I'm telling you, you know, for those of us that know other people that maybe are walking in this place, that you will offer them help, remind them that there are options to be safe, and give me a call because I know some of those options. So you are loved. God is love, and perfect love casts out all fear. So let us pray. God, we come before you today, acknowledging that too often we have forgotten your perfect love. We have allowed for violence, whether it is the violent words we use against ourselves or the violence in the world around us that we participate in. We have allowed that to define our culture and our world around us. And you remind us again and again that if we can live in your love, if we can accept your perfect love, then there is no fear. Your perfect love casts out all fear. So lead us this day, Lord, out of our places of fear and into places of new life, of new possibility, places in which we feel safe and secure, places where we know we are loved with an everlasting, unconditional love. We need you today, Lord. We need your perfect love. And so guide us in ways that will bring life for our own selves and for the world around us. We ask all of this in your name, Lord Jesus, as together we pray the prayer that you taught your disciples. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. So my friends, perfect love, God's love, God is love, casts out all fear. May you experience that this day. God loves you, my friends, and so do I. Have a very blessed day, and I will see you back here tomorrow. Enjoy the sun. Bye, friends.